Chapter 5, Magnetism and Matter. Okay, we have done about the history of the magnetism, then we have done some common ideas, bar magnet, magnetic field lines and its property. Today, we shall study bar magnet as an equivalent solenoid. So, we have to show that bar magnet and solenoid have got the same magnetism. Okay, so they behave like the solenoid also behaves like a bar magnet. Consider a solenoid of length 2L. Radius small a consisting of n number of turns per unit length. Okay, in this figure, okay, this is the figure. In this figure, this is a solenoid of length 2L. So the length is 2L, the total length is 2L. This is the axis of the solenoid. Okay, and this is the center of the solenoid, call it O. The radius of the solenoid is A, and we'll take the number of turns per unit length is n. Okay, and I want to find the magnetic field at the point on the axis at point P. At distance r from the center O of the solenoid. Let P be a point on its axis at distance r from center O of solenoid. Consider a circular element of thickness dx of solenoid at distance x from center O. Here, now I am considering this black color, you can see that is the element dx thickness, that means the length of this element is dx. Okay, this I have drawn like this, means this thickness is dx and its distance from the center, this distance from the center is taken as x. Okay, the distance is taken as x. Now if suppose it has the thickness is dx, the number of unit turn number of turns per unit length is n. Okay, we have taken n number of turn per unit length and dx is the thickness for this element, then how many number of turns will be here? It will be multiplication of these two, n into dx. This many number of turns will be on this dx, this element. Okay. So I have written here it. It consists number of turns and dx. Okay, as I said, n is number of per unit length, and in dx, if I want to find the number of turns, it will be n into dx. Let I be current in the solenoid, and we consider current is I. We know by Biot-Savart's law, magnitude of field, that is magnetic field on the axis at distance r due to circular loop is this much. B is equal to mu naught n I r square divided by 2 x square plus r square power 3 by 2 I cap, where r is the radius of the loop. This we have done in last chapter. Okay, we have taken a single turn and we have found the magnetic field at the distance x on the axis. What is the magnetic field? This is this much. Okay, if you are writing magnitude, then know the vector sign. Okay, but I have written here magnitude, but I am writing in a vector sign. If no vector sign, no magnitude, no vector, then you just remove this I cap and B. Magnitude is this much. Now I am going to apply this for our solenoid. Okay, so see, now I am going to take number of turn in this, okay, because of this loop. So number of turn I will take n ds. Okay, then a radius will be A, and the distance is R. Actually, the distance in there, what we have done is, it was like this. Okay, you can just recall like this. This was my loop. Okay, this is the center of the loop. The radius was taken as capital R, and the distance from here was S. At this point P, we had found. Okay, now this is my center O. So this distance is from O to P is taken as R. In that we have taken as R. So O to P is R. Now I have to write from distance of P, this point P, from the dx. Okay. So I have to take from here. So from here I have to take distance of the point P. So how to take? See, from the center the distance, total distance is R, and the dx distance is dx. Okay. So what happens? Distance of dx from O is x, and the distance of P is from O is R. So I want to find distance from here till here. Okay, because we are considering this. So the distance from here till here will be R minus this distance. R minus this distance. This is taken as X. So R minus X. The distance will become, instead of this R, my distance from dx to this point is R minus X. Okay. So now we have to replace. So in this formula, I am going to replace. So n, that is number of turn in my unit, in my dx area, is n ds. Okay, the radius is taken as a, and x, the distance of the point from the center of the loop is, here it is r minus x, I showed you in the figure. Field due to ds at point p, okay, in this I am going to change. dB is equal to mu naught. Instead of n, you put n ds. I will be same. Instead of radius, it will become a square. Divide by 2 as it is. Instead of x, it will be r minus x. Okay, this is r. This is not, this is x. Yeah, that is x only, sorry. That we have taken as x only. So this x is equal to r minus x, okay, for us. So r minus x whole square plus instead of r, it is a. So a square and power 3 by 2, okay. Now, the magnetic field of total field is by integrating dB from minus L to plus L. This magnitude, okay, not magnitude. So the magnitude of the total field. Now this dB is only for the dx length or dx thickness. Okay, I want the total solenoid. Then I have to consider from the length of the total, that is minus L to L. Actually 2L, but I'm taking center as origin. So both the sides you can say LL, so minus L to plus L. So we will integrate. The total magnitude of the magnetic field is B equal to integral minus L to L, this dB. Put this dB value here. So I have put the value. Now here, for short solenoid, R is very, very greater than A. And R is very, very greater than A. We'll consider that this R, the point P is very far compared to the radius and compared to the length of the solenoid. Okay. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to neglect X and I'm going to neglect A. Therefore, the denominator neglecting X and A. So I will just take first denominator, not to this denominator which is in the bracket. R minus x whole square plus a square power 3 by 2. X will become 0 by a 0 because we are neglecting. So here remains r square power 3 by 2. Cut 2 to you remain r cube. Okay. So b will be equal to, I will take mu naught n dx I. Sorry, mu naught n I a square then 2 and this all. Okay. I will take common. This I am not taking still. I have just kept here. So I am taking mu naught. And I a square divided by 2 is taken common, taken out of the integral because it is constant. Integral minus L to L and here remains dx and this value I have written from here r cube. Okay, r cube also is constant now, so I am just taking out and I will integrate only dx. So integral of dx, this is the formula, integral of dx is equal to x plus c. We shall see this in the mathematics also. This is the formula, integral of 1 dx will be x with respect to x is x and plus c. Plus C is when limit is not given. Here limit is given, so C I will not write. Okay, so for here it becomes mu naught n I a square by 2x square and x minus L to L. Now we have to apply the limit. So we apply first positive limit minus, we have to apply the lower limit. This is upper limit, this is lower limit. Upper limit minus minus lower limit. So this minus and minus plus, so it becomes 2L and this is as it is. Now multiply and divide by 2 pi. So I am multiplying divided by 2 pi. Okay, and I am also rearranging. So this mu naught is here. This n is here. This 2l I am writing here. Into I is here. A square is here. And 2 pi which I have multiplied here. Okay, I have just separated. Because I want to say this is the area of the cross section area. Okay, and this 2 pi is here. Now here, now I am writing this pi a square as the A cross sectional area. Then n into 2l will be the total number of turns because 2l is the total length, n is the number turns per unit length, so this together will become total number of turns. Okay, now we can write this in mu naught. This n into 2n is capital N, I is as it is, and this has area, and this 2 into 2 4 pi r cube, and this 2 is here. Now again, this we have learned before, that is magnetic moment of solenoid. So m is equal to n I a, I ampere current into cross section area. These two products will become m. If it is number of turns are n, then you multiply n. So together this value is magnetic moment vector n. Okay, for solenoid. So put the value b is equal to mu naught 2 m divided by 4 pi r cube. This is also the axial field of a bar magnet. This is done, if for bar magnet you can do by experimentally. Thus a bar magnet and solenoid produce similar magnetic field. Therefore, magnetic moment of bar magnet is equal to magnetic moment of equivalent solenoid that produces same magnetic field. Okay, so this is your theory of, we can say that bar magnet is equivalent solenoid. Okay, then in some textbook they have mentioned these lines. Okay, so I'm just writing these lines. Magnetic charge of north and south is plus Q and minus Q. Okay, we already saw before. And the length of bar magnet is 2L. Then field due to QM at R is mu naught QM divided by 4 pi R square. Magnetic field due to bar magnet at axial and equatorial point is analogous to that of electric dipole, chapter 1. Okay, and we can find the magnetic field using electric analogous means similarity with the electric dipole in chapter 1. Magnetic moment is given by 2L into QN, and this is magnetic moment N. Okay, but we are not doing this. Why we are not doing this? Because we know that magnetic monopole does not exist. Therefore, we are not doing this. But if you have to prove that bar magnet as equivalent solenoid, then you have to prove up to here. Okay, so we'll keep this much today. Next, we will do the next topic of this chapter. Okay, so this is bar magnet as an equivalent solenoid. Thank you very much.